Hey guys, welcome back. Now, there really are just so many benefits of having a virtual machine on your computer. For example, the ability to test out different operating systems. So let's say, for example, you're running Windows 10, but you want to try out Unix, or you want to try out Linux Mint or Debian or any of the other operating systems. You can do all of that inside a virtual machine without affecting your main machine. Also, for example, if you have some legacy or older software which is only compatible with an older version of Windows, again, you can install that older version of Windows inside a virtual machine and then continue using that older software. And also the key benefit that a virtual machine does run inside a sandbox. So for example, if you did want to test out some software which may be malicious, or if you're not really confident with a certain web link, then you can happily open that up inside your virtual machine and none of that will really have impact on your primary machine. So as you can see, guys, so many benefits of having a virtual machine on your computer. So in this video today, let me show you the step-by-step guide on how you can also install Windows 10 or really any operating system that you like inside a virtual machine on your computer, coming up right after this. Now, for this process to work, we need to have just two things on our computer. First, you need to have some virtual machine software. In my example, I'm going to use Oracle Virtualbox. And then secondly, you need to have the actual operating system you want to install. Now, in my example, I'm going to use Windows 10, and I'll show you exactly how you can download that software image. Okay, so first up, let's get Oracle Virtualbox. So open up your favorite browser and just type in Virtualbox into the search box. And you have the link here, which is Oracle VM VirtualBox. Now, in terms of hardware requirements, as long as your main computer is fairly recent, then this should really work without any problems whatsoever. So let's go to downloads. And because my main computer is a Windows computer, I'm going to click on Windows Host, which will then begin the download of VirtualBox for Windows. Okay, let's leave that running. And we now want to download Windows 10 because that's the operating system I'm going to be installing on my computer. But let's say, for example, you want to install Linux, like perhaps Ubuntu. I can just type that into Google. So Ubuntu ISO download. Click here, and this will then give you the ISO image you can use to install into a virtual machine. But for us, we're looking for Windows. Let's just type in Windows 10 ISO. And you want to click on the first link in the results. And we want to download the Windows 10 installation media. Let's click on download now. And it's actually a tool that will be downloaded. Okay, so you've got the VirtualBox down here and you've got the media creation tool. So let's do the VirtualBox first. Okay, let's click on next. Leave all the default options and click on next again. We can leave all of these ticked and click on next. You'll then see this warning that you may get a slight blip in your network because it's going to install some virtual network adapters for you. We can click on yes and click on install. Click on yes, and that should then go ahead and install Oracle VirtualBox on your computer. Once that's done, we'll then need to download the ISO for Windows 10. Okay, let's uncheck this box and click on finish. Okay, let's now open up the media creation tool. Click on yes, and this will allow us to download a Windows 10 ISO image direct from Microsoft. But if you already have the image for Windows 10 or whichever operating system you want to install, then you can actually miss out this step. But for now, let's click on accept. So when you see this screen, select the second option, which is I want to create some installation media. And what we're looking for is actually an ISO image we can use to build out our new virtual machine. Let's click on next. Make sure you're happy with the options here. But if you want to change something, click on this here. And let's say I'm going to go for 32-bit. I can select that. Or for example, if I want to go for a different language pack, like for example, UK, I can select that. But let's leave this at 64-bit and click on next. And here we select the option for ISO file, which means it's going to download an ISO image directly onto my computer. Let's click on next. We can choose a location for the ISO file. Let's just do the desktop and click on save. And this will now download that Windows 10 ISO image directly onto your desktop. So let's give that a minute. Again, here is the Windows 10 ISO that's just been downloaded. Let's just check the file size. And we can see that's just under 4 gigs. Okay, let's now start Oracle VirtualBox. Okay, let's now create our first virtual machine. So let's click on new. Let's give this a name. So I'm going to call this pcdoctorukyt. And I'll just write it's Win10 because it is running Windows 10. So you can give it a descriptive name just so you know exactly what the virtual machine is. For example, I could say brackets software testing. Okay, then choose a location for your virtual machine, but I'm going to leave it as default. And here we need to specify what you're actually installing. So in our case, it is Microsoft Windows, but in fact, it's Windows 10 64-bit. Let's click on Next. And we now need to specify how much RAM we're going to give to the virtual machine. And for Windows-based computers, I would say always go for a minimum of 2 gig, which is 2048 megabytes. That's 2 gig of virtual RAM. Let's click on Next. And we now need to specify a location for the virtual hard disk and also a size for the virtual hard disk. So we can leave the default name here. So the virtual hard disk is going to be called pcdoctorukyt.vdi. Now this is the individual file, which is what the hard disk is going to be. And the maximum size of this file will be 50 gig. Now that's the great thing about having dynamically allocated space. Even though we set this as 50 gig, this file size is not going to be 50 gig. It's going to be depending on how much stuff we store inside the virtual machine. So even though we set this as 50 gig, this is not going to be 50 gig on day one. It just means that the file size can grow to 50 gig. Let's click on Create. And that's all done, guys. So in fact, let's just have a quick look at that virtual hard disk just so I can show you once again. Go into your C drive, go into your users, find your user account, click on VirtualBox VMs, and here is the folder for the new VM. Let's click on that. And here is the virtual hard disk. So everything you install, everything you do inside your virtual machine, all of that will be stored into this single file. And right now the file size is just 2 meg because we haven't actually turned this on. Let's close that down. Now the last thing we want to do before we power this on is attach our ISO image of Windows 10. And there's a couple of ways you can do that, but probably the easiest is just click on this thing here where it says optical drive empty and select the option choose a disk file. Let's click on that. And we now want to find the Windows 10 ISO image that we downloaded, and mine was just on the desktop. Let's select that, click on open. And that basically means when we turn on the virtual machine, that will read the contents of this ISO image, which will then commence the installation of Windows 10. So once you've checked everything looks okay, let's now click on Start. And here it is, guys. Here is our virtual machine powered up, reading the ISO image, and it's now asking us to select some options before it begins the installation of Windows 10. So let's just change these options. If you want to do that, click on Next, and let's click on Install Now. Now, all of this is happening inside a virtual machine, and none of this will actually affect anything on my main machine. We can click on I don't have a product key for now. Let's select this option here. Let's choose a version of Windows. Let's just go for Pro. Let's go for Next. Let's accept the license agreement. Click on Next. And we're not going to do an upgrade. We're going to do a clean installation. So let's select the second option. Here we can see the virtual 50 gig hard disk. And let's click on Next. And there we have it, guys. We are now installing Windows 10 inside a virtual machine. So let's give that a minute, then I'll talk you through some of the key things we can do with VirtualBox. Okay, that's nearly finished. This will now probably reboot. There we go. Let's click on restart now, just speed things up a bit. And guys, just while we're waiting, if you are enjoying this kind of content, then please do take a minute to hit that like button and also think about subscribing if you want to see more content like this. Now, to be fair, this actually came via a comment in one of my previous videos. A couple of you are asking, you know, what's the easiest way to install a virtual machine on our computer? So because of those comments, I created this video. So again, if there's any particular videos you do want to see on this channel, then please do leave me a comment below. Thank you. And here we can now start the configuration process for Windows 10. A quick tip here, guys, is Microsoft really are pushing people to log in with Microsoft accounts into Windows 10 instead of using local accounts. And they really have made the process a bit tricky where if you don't know what you're doing, it will almost feel like you have to use an online account to actually log in. And the way we get around that is we need to basically disable our virtual network card, because Windows 10 will see that this person does not have an internet connection. And if you don't have an internet connection, then you're not going to be able to log in using an online account. And you'll then see the prompt to log in using a local account. Now, if this was a physical Windows 10 machine, then all you need to do is disable either the Wi-Fi, or if you're using an Ethernet cable, you can basically just unplug that cable, so you now have no internet access. But on a virtual machine, if you go down here, we can see the one here, which has the two small computers, is your virtual network card. If I right click on that, okay, let's click on yes, choose the correct keyboard, click on yes, skip this here. And here is the key thing here, guys. It's now saying that you don't have an internet connection and it's asking you to connect. So all you want to do here is just say, I don't have internet. And this should then give us the option to create a local account. And again, we can see it's trying to convince you to use an online account because you get all these extra benefits here. But I want to say continue with limited setup. And I should then be able to create a local account. So let's give this a name. So this is pcdoctorukyt 001 test account. Let's click on next. Let's give it a password. Let's do something really secure. Security question. So first pet name was Alpha. Not really. Okay, so here are some of the privacy options. So I'm going to click on no. No digital assistant needed. And basically just say no for all of these options. So accept, no, basic, accept, no, accept. You get the idea, guys. That's it, guys. We've now actually fully configured our Windows 10 machine. We can now test software in here. We can now download things in here and also just do the things that you may not want to do on your main machine. Like, for example, I know certain people only download torrents inside a virtual machine, just so if they are downloading something and maybe there may be something malicious or problematic, because that's inside a virtual machine, they know it's not going to affect their main machine. Now, to fix the display and also improve the performance, if you go over to devices and select insert guest edition CD image, and this is basically a bunch of drivers for your virtual machine which will greatly improve the performance. Let's click on that now and click on run VirtualBox editions. Let's click on yes and let's just go through the next, make sure everything is ticked. Click on install and that should then fix the display. Let's click on install. Let's restart the virtual machine just so those new drivers can take effect. And let's see what happens to the display. Let's do a right click on the desktop, select display settings, and we can now change this resolution and go for something a little bit higher. Okay, so we've installed the drivers, we fixed the resolution. Let's now lastly reconnect our network adapter or our virtual network adapter. Let's go to devices, go to network, and select the option connect network adapter. Okay, that's now connected. Let's go back here, go to network settings, let's change that back to NAT and click on OK. Okay, once that's done, let's now see if we can access the internet. And there we are, guys. We now have full internet access on our virtual machine. We can now browse content, we can download things, and anything we do inside our virtual machine won't affect our main machine. So really, guys, it's as easy as that. Well, guys, many thanks for watching this video, and I really appreciate you staying till the end. If you did find this video useful, then do give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more content like this, then do subscribe and hit the notification bell. As always, I always appreciate your likes, your shares, your comments, so do let me know what you think. Leave me a comment below, and I'll hopefully catch up with you guys real soon. Thanks.